Have you had any interesting or entertaining moments when you were making the Yes Minister series?
Well, I remember on one occasion I was conducting an economy drive within my department. I decided to use my own car in order to go to a reception at the French Embassy, and of course it broke down in the middle of a rainstorm. So I appeared very bedraggled in evening dress at the embassy, had rather too much champagne, fell down in the gutter afterwards and was photographed trying to find my car keys in the gutter by the press, you see. I shouted "gutter press" at them. That was in the episode. Well, to shoot this was quite difficult. It was difficult to find somewhere that looked like the French Embassy where we could do all this without attracting crowds of sightseers and so on. So just before Christmas, a couple of years ago, we found number one Carlton House Terrace, just behind Pall Mall, on a dark Sunday night. Absolutely nobody about, totally deserted. So we started to film this. I lay down in the gutter, hose pipes were showered over me, at which point about 5,000 Boy Scouts and Girl Guides, accompanied by about four or five Salvation Army bands, started to march down Pall Mall in order to sing carols to the Queen. So we had to abandon filming for an hour or two and go and sit in caravans in sodden evening dress. This is just before Christmas, remember, to eat chicken Kiev and have a glass of brandy to try and warm ourselves up, and then go back and lie down in the gutter again. It's not as glamorous as some people think.
No, certainly a lot of commitment to the series. And I hear that Margaret Thatcher finds it one of her most interesting programmes. She enjoys that series.
Well, people keep telling me, yes. I mean, people who appear to know.
Yes. Have you any tips for the election?
Well, most people think that there are three principal contenders. There's the Conservative Party, the Labour Party, and the Alliance. It's my feeling that there are actually four. There's a hidden, as it were, fourth column. That's the civil service. And I think it's probably the civil service who, irrespective of the number of votes any of the others might get, they're the people who are actually going to win the election.